Hi there, it's AJ here from AJ's Design Lab. In this series of videos, I'm looking at some of the ways that I can take this WordPress website and speed it up. Now, WordPress is known for being a little bit on the sluggish side, so anything that we can do to speed up the site has got to be good. The first thing I want to do is update my PHP version. Currently I'm using 5.6, which is getting a little bit out of date now. The latest version is 7.3. Whether or not I'll see any performance gains remains to be seen. So to do this, you need access to your cPanel. So that's where I'm heading now, is to my cPanel, which I'm using GoDaddy hosting, so your cPanel interface might look a little different than this. I'm going to do a search for version. Here we are. I'm looking for select PHP version, which is under the software section. Now, if you're using something like SiteGround, I believe it's called PHP version management. Anyway, we'll click on that and have a look inside. And we can see my current PHP version is 5.6. So I'm going to use the drop down here and see what we've got. We can go right up to 7.3, so that's the one I'm going to check. Now I'm going to set as current, and then I'm going to go down and save. Okay, I've got the modules set saved success message there, so that should be my PHP version updated. Now, if you're worried about whether or not this is going to break your site, if you've got a modern theme and you're using modern, well-maintained plugins that are regularly updated, then you should have no problems. But if you're still concerned about it, just download a plugin called PHP Compatibility Checker and run that. This will check all the themes that you've got and your plugins, and it will bring back the results as to whether or not it's going to be compatible for higher PHP versions. This does have rather mixed reviews, and most of the complaints seem to center around the fact that it not only takes a long time to run, but it tends to skip over a lot of plugins. That's because it's too big. I have used this, and while it seemed to work fine for me, I don't think I'd bother using it again. The reason is it takes a long time and I use up-to-date plugins anyway, so I'm not expecting any problems. If I did, all I would do is go back to my cPanel and go down a version until I found one that everything worked. Just remember that when you do this, if you have more than one website on your hosting plan, you are of course changing the PHP version for all of them. Anyway, let's just go to PageSpeed Insights and check what our speed is. So I'm just going to check that now, and let's just refresh our memory with the time that we had here on our baseline scores: 63 for desktop, 23 for mobile, and a performance grade of 68 and a D at pingdom. Okay, that should be just about finished. Let's have a look. 64 and 26 compared to 63 and 23. So there's a small but measurable increase in performance there. What about at pingdom? I'll just copy and paste my URL. And you do of course want to make sure you use the same server every time here, so that you're comparing apples with apples. And when I checked, I used this particular one here, the Sydney one. Okay, so the test is run and my performance grade is still D, as I expected, and my score was 70. Let's just compare that to what I had, which was 68, so a fractional improvement. Load time has gone from 3.5 seconds, or almost 3.5 seconds, to 2.5 seconds. Excellent. And if you're wondering why the requests are different, 89 versus 92, I just removed a couple of unused HTTP requests from my header, so that is the reason. Anyway, we've got a small but measurable improvement, and it's a good start. So in the next video, I'm going to look at adding a caching plugin. Thanks for watching.